Hello people, this is Code Grind and in today's video we'll be designing our very own custom cursor. As we all know, we are bored of that boring arrow cursor, so why not try something new? So here it how the final project will look like. We have a circular cursor with a crimson colored border, and whenever you hover it over any text, it just transforms like this. So I know you all are eager to learn how to make this, so let's get straight into it. So let's get started with the coding part. Now as you can see, I have a basic layout ready over here, and I also have a live server running. I have an index.css file linked over here. It is the file in which we will be doing all the styling part. And I also have an external font from Google Fonts. Its name is Poppins, and I really like the font and I'll be using it for all the text part. So now let's get started with the HTML part. First, let's have our text ready. Let's call the div a menu. Then we will have four spans, first, second, third, and fourth. So here you can see we have all we have got them ready. Now let's style them. Font family of, as I told you, I'll be using Poppins from Google Fonts. I will give a link to the font in the description below. Yeah, now we have got the font. Now let's style the menu. Let's give it a display of flex, justify content center. Center is a bit sticky, so let's give space around. Yeah, it looks good now. And also let's give them a margin top of, let's say, 10%. Yeah, 10% looks good. It will work for us. Now let's get our cursor ready. So for cursor, what we will have is just a div with a class cursor. Now we just need to style it, and the rest will be taken care by JavaScript. So to style it, first let's give it a position absolute so that we can position it according to the cursor. Let's get a height of 30 pixel. Width of 30 pixel as well. Now we can't see it anywhere because there is no text, no background color, no border, nothing. So let's also give it a border of, let's say, 5 pixel solid crimson. No, 5 pixel is a lot. Let's reduce it to 2 pixels. Yeah, 2 pixel looks good. Now let's make it circle by applying a border radius of 50%. Yeah, now it is a proper circle. Now what we need to do is we need to position it as according to our cursor. Now you see I have this arrow cursor. We need this div to move along with the cursor, so we need to get the position of the cursor as well. Now to get the position of the cursor, we have a basic JavaScript code for it. Now I will show you how to get it. So let's first write the script. And over here, what we need to do it, we need to call an event listener. So window dot event listener mouse move. So this function will be called whenever the mouse is moved along the window. Let's call an event over here, and let's console dot log the event. Yeah. So now let's open the inspect element over here. Yeah, here we have the inspect element console. Now you see we have these all the mouse events already over here because we have moved the mouse a lot. Now as I move the mouse, you see this, the console.log gets increasing because we call it every time the mouse is moved. So let's just clear all this, and now yeah. So now let's just take any one of these and show it. So now we have all these properties. The property which we need is this one. So this basically tells us the position of the cursor. Let me zoom it in. Now as you can see, we have this page X and page Y, which will tell us the position of the cursor. the page X means it will give us the coordinates from the left of the window, and page Y means it will give us the coordinates from the top of the window. That means 149 means the cursor is 149 pixels from the left of the window and 98 pixels from the top of the window. So we will be using this property. Now let's get to this JavaScript part. So let's first have the cursor over here in the const cursor by document.query selector. Yeah, we have it. Now we will be styling it by cursor.style.top. We can use the top styling because we have given the position of absolute to the cursor, so we can use the top. It is similar to this top. Now we need to it to be dynamic, so we are giving it using JavaScript. So it needs to be e.pageY. We also need to add pixels over here. And same goes for the left. And instead of page Y, we will have page X. So this is a very cool feature, and you can use it for many other things also, like for ripple effect of a button. I will be making a video on that later. So this is it. Now as you can see, the div is moving along with the cursor, but still you can see that it is not exactly at the center of the cursor. So for that, what we need to do is we need to give it a transform translate of -50% comma -50%. Now it's perfectly at the moves with the center, as you can see over here. Now we don't want this cursor to be displayed, so let's give the cursor none. So we don't have any cursor now, and it just works completely fine. So this is how we will be designing the cursor. Now as you can see, this cursor is above the text, so whenever I am selecting it, it isn't selecting. So we need it below the text, so we need to give it a z index of -1. Now you see I am able to select the text because it is below the text. Earlier it was above the text, so we weren't able to select anything. So this works perfectly now. Now what we need to do is we need to scale it up when we hover over the text. So for that, let's give it a class. Let's say scale up transform scale to, and we also need to change its background color from white to crimson. Now we will add this class to the cursor whenever we hover over the text. So for that, what we need to do is first we will select all the spans from the page. Let's call it menu items, and we have document.query selector all. We are using query selector all because we have multiple spans in the document. Now we will run a for each loop for every span. Like this. And what we will do is we will add an event listener, and whenever the mouse is over that span, we will call a function. And we will add the class scale up to the cursor like this. So whenever the mouse is over hovering over any of the span tags, the class list we will add a class scale up to the cursor div. So whenever we hover, a class like scale up will add like this over here. Now let's test this. So as you can see, but what we also need to do is once it scales up, we also need to remove it whenever the mouse leaves the span tag. So for that we need to add another function, and this time instead of mouse over, what we will use is mouse leave, and instead of adding, we will remove the class. Let's save it. Now test it. It scales up, and as soon as we leave, it scales down. So it's working perfectly fine, but we also need to give it a transition. So let's give it a transition of, let's say, 0.3 seconds. Transform ease. Now if you'll see, it transitions very, the transition is very smooth now. So we have got this all sorted. Now we also need to change the color of the text whenever we hover over it. The black over crimson doesn't look good. We need, let's change it to something like, let's say, white. So what we need to do is come here and give the menu item a color of white, and whenever the mouse leaves it, the color should go back to black. So now let's check it. Yeah, it works perfectly. But now, even now, if you see, the text doesn't come to the center perfectly. So for that, we have got another property in CSS which we need to use, and which will be transform origin 100% from the top, 100% from the left. And now let's check it. So as you see, it is perfect now. So this is how you can make a custom cursor of your own. You can also give it different shapes according to your preference. And I really like this one. You can use it in your websites. It will look really cool whenever a user visits it. It will make your website very interactive. And this is how it works. I will provide you with the source code in the link in the description box. And if you have any queries related to it, you can drop a comment on the comments box, and I will definitely clear every one of your queries. So if you like the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more such amazing tutorials on CSS and JavaScript. And thank you for watching.